I was able to speak with former Iloilo Mayor Jed Mabilog as he finally breaks his silence on his decision to leave the country and why he plans to return soon. Here is our exclusive interview with former Iloilo Mayor Jed Mabilog. And we have with us for this exclusive interview, former Iloilo Mayor Mabilog. Sir, good morning to you from wherever you are.
Good morning, Ma'am Karen. Good morning po to all who are watching this program right now of yours.
All right. Now, it's been 7 years since you've been in the Philippines. You have been abroad in exile for close to 7 years. Is that correct? From the time former President Duterte included you in his narco list. Is it close to 7 years now, sir?
Yes, ma'am. It is exactly 7 years in the month of September of this year.
All right.
Yes.
So you have been in hiding during the time of the former president. Why did you choose to leave the country instead of face the charges?
Well, I decided to leave the country at that time because there were threats against my life and security. When I left the country on official travel to be speaker for an international conference in Japan, yes, there were existing pending complaints filed against me in the ombudsman. Mm-hmm. Unfortunately for me, these cases were heard without my defense, and the court rulings were made. That is why I would like to return and face to prove my innocence. I was also afraid of the reports about the extrajudicial killings in the country. If you remember, madaming pinapatay noong panahon na yon, lalo na kapag na-involve ang pangalan sa droga. Walang basehan ang mga paratang laban sa akin. Natatakot lang po talaga ako sa sarili at lalo na po para sa aking pamilya. As I said, I am ready to face these allegations against me, pero sana sa tamang proseso sa korte. However, wala pong na-file na kaso laban sa akin sa drug issues.
Walang na-file na kaso laban sa iyo sa drug issues. But if we go back to 2017, the former president even subjected you to a lifestyle check, accused you of your involvement with the illegal drug trade, and questioned even the legitimacy of your home. The former president accused you of living in a mansion, a palace, mm-hmm. accused essentially you of graft and corruption without the formal charges. Is that correct?
Yes, that is true. He just unfairly accused me of putting these accusations left and right, baseless accusations left and right. As a matter of fact, my house still in Iloilo City is only a 200 square meter, stands on a 200 square meter property. So how can it be a mansion? The NBI has visited my place for twice. And, you know, not only that, CIDG, PIDEA, PNP, and even the Philippine National Police has also visited and has also checked on me. But as of now, wala po talaga sila makikita na anything that could put my name involved in the illegal drug trade. So there is nothing that they have found that would substantiate these accusations, Paul.
Oh, and the former president during that time even quoted these words. He said you were the most shabulized. He called Iloilo City that. Do you remember that, sir?
Yes, That is why if you would check on the list that he made when he read and called Iloilo City as most shabbolized on the 81 provinces and 27 cities listed by PIDEA, Iloilo province ranked 79th of 81. Of the least, and Iloilo City was 51st. As a matter of fact, in that PIDEA list, nowhere can you find in the top 10 that Iloilo City belongs to that category, not even in the top 50. So there is no basis for him to call Iloilo as most shabbolized. As a matter of fact, ma'am, I was at that time, I made multiple attempts to meet him, to face him, and tell him that these accusations were false and politically motivated. I wanted to ask him what was his basis. I want to show to him a detailed book compilation of my and the city's anti-illegal drug programs that even received national rewards and recognition from PIDEA and from the Philippine National Police themselves. So there was, again, I stand that there is no basis for him to accuse me of being a protector of illegal drugs and at the same time calling Iloilo City a shabbolized, the most shabbolized city.
So it means that in 2017, before you escaped, so to speak, is you tried to reach out to the former president and you tried to actually meet with him, but he declined?
Yes, unfortunately, I didn't have the opportunity and chance to meet him. Yes, but I did have several attempts. I even went to Davao. I even went to, try to made several attempts to meet him, but I didn't have the chance and opportunity to do this.
So why do you think did the president, do you feel you were targeted? Was this personal? Why do you think then did the president accuse you of frankly being a drug protector? Where would this be coming from?
Actually, that was the reason why I really wanted to meet him, because I really wanted to know the facts on what was his basis. But personally, as you asked me, I think that his basis was because of a personal vendetta of that he had against my person because of several incidents that happened before, but I have never ever have these are all like speculations, like there were attempts that when he was still running for president he wanted to meet me, he went to Iloilo, but at that time I was in Manila because of a special project to bring down the spaghetti lines along the national highway. And I have to meet some corporate executives owned by those lines.
So
I wasn't able to meet him, yes. And second is when he had his own political rally in Iloilo City, during that rally, he had the brownout. So in the plaza. So again, that all are just like my personal speculations, or because it has never been, proven that that was the reason why he got mad at me. Also, after the elections of four candidates running for president, he got the lowest vote. And that was all over the country. So as well as there was, he was, like Davao was always compared to Iloilo. And Iloilo was always better than Davao during his term as mayor while I was mayor of Iloilo City. Again, I am not sure of this, if these are the real reasons, because I never had the chance to meet him and talk to him about it.
Okay. All right. So you said it yourself. These are speculations. But do you believe that if there was a motive, it would be political vendetta?
Yes, definitely. And aside from that, of course, I did not support him in that particular presidential election. If you would notice, ma'am, that there was a lot of persecution when he became president. As a matter of fact, tri-media, the judiciary, legislation, all those mayors also on that particular list that I personally know have been those who were not politically aligned with him at that time were all persecuted. So all right. one way or another.
Okay. But then, you know, somebody might be asking right now and say, you know, there were many Filipino citizens who may have felt persecuted, right? And I think in the last 6 years, there have been several issues of red tagging. And there's an investigation right now by the ICC on the EJ case. Some would be watching and think, why would he not face the charges, considering he was a sitting mayor, he was elected by the people, you did have power and influence, why escape? So you won as mayor as 2016, and yet you left the country 2017, is this correct,
yes.
Mayor? Okay,
yes.
So bakit, kumbaga, sasabihin ng ilang nanonood, grabe naman yon ang ordinaryong Pilipino, hindi kayang tumakas. Tapos eto siya, may kakayanan, mayor, binoto ng tao. Ba't di na lang niya nilabanan? Diba? Lumaban siya sa korte.
Sana ganun nga ang nangyari. But when he made mention, several times, I think not only once, but more than 10 times that he has threatened my life, that he even used the word na papatayin niya talaga ako. So it would have been good if he would have followed the rule of law and cases were filed against me, because I was ready to face them in court. I have all the documents that would prove of my performance and my campaign against anti-illegal drugs and crime in my city. And again, that's what I told you earlier, that we have even received, Iloilo City and myself have been receiving national awards from the PIDEA for our anti-drug campaign. Not only once, but we got it in 2014, 2015, and 2016. And I have only been mayor for 6 years. Mm-hmm. And 3 years of that, we have been receiving succeedingly national awards from the PIDEA themselves.
Okay.
So I was quite surprised when my name was included in that particular list.
But Mr. Mabilog, are you saying that, frankly, the reason you left the country, that you fled, was because you believed, one, your life was in danger, and number two, you wouldn't get a fair trial under the Duterte administration?
Yes, ma'am. As a matter of fact, you could even see, I was waiting for cases to be filed against me in terms of these drug-related cases. And till now, there's none, because they have nothing against me. So how could I face a fair trial? And aside from that, as what I've said, there is the physical threat. Mm-hmm. He himself, in several public announcements, made those announcements that he was napapatayin niya talaga ako. Mm-hmm. So that is why. On that day when I was on official travel for an international conference in Japan, I decided not to return.
I'm going to ask you about you leaving the country in detail later on, but just to go back to the case. So the ombudsman found you guilty of a serious dishonesty. And in 2021, the Court of Appeals dismissed the administrative complaint against you and cleared you of the charges, right? So in 2021, somebody might be asking, why didn't you come back then? You were already cleared by the Court of Appeals.
In 2021, well, there is this fear of my life and of my family, ma'am. Because after God, it's my family that matters most. So if there is the threat, so we've decided not to return until such time that we would be able to see that things are favorable, meaning that we can finally find justice, just like what is happening right now in Congress. And I would like to thank Congress of the invitation to appear in their Quad Committee, as well as in that particular committee, Colonel Jovi Espinido has been spilling out the beans. So this would only show that the government, the present government under the Marcos administration, have been showing that fairness and that it's giving us the opportunity to be able to come back, to return to the Philippines and to be able to defend ourselves and clear our names.
Okay, so now let's go to 2017. You were in a speaking engagement in Japan and you have decided not to come back to the country. You have been away for 7 years. Clearly, you are overstaying. Are you willing to state right now on Head Start which country took you in? Nasaan po ba kayo nitong nakaraang pitong taon, sir?
Right now, we are in the United States of America.
So what is the status? Are you overstaying in the United States? Did the U.S. grant you asylum? Did they allow you to stay there for 7 years? Please explain.
Yes, ma'am. They have granted us asylum and they are allowing us to stay here for as long as we want under that status.
So the United States granted you political asylum. What did that mean to you? That seems to mean that the U.S. feels you are politically harassed in the Philippines and your charges were somehow baseless. Why? On what grounds would they grant you political asylum?
That is very true, because what actually happened is not a secret. Everybody knows it, that what happened in the Philippines during the Duterte administration, that there were a lot of threats, there were persecutions, there were a lot of deaths. Marami pong namamatay ng walang basihan. So with this, we are very thankful with the United States government for granting us asylum. So we are just staying here until such time that, again, we see that we have the opportunity to be able to defend, to come back home and defend ours, to defend myself and my name from these false accusations.
You were in Japan for a speaking engagement. What happened, sir? From Japan, did you fly to the U.S. directly?
Oh, yes. What happened was you did that. Yes, ma'am.
Oh, with your family, Mr. Mabilog, or by yourself?
With my family. What happened then was at that particular day, my family flew from Iloilo to Manila and Manila to Japan. And together we flew to the United States.
And when you flew to the United States, you first flew as a tourist, or did you already apply for political asylum with the U.S. when you were still in Japan?
No, we flew first to the United States, then we applied for asylum.
Okay. And when you applied for political asylum, take us through the process. Did the U.S. do their own investigation on your person? Because to a degree, with the U.S. granting you political asylum, and to think former President Duterte was in office then, it means they somehow believed you, that you were not a drug trafficker or a drug protector. What was it like, that process?
The United States has very strict laws with regards to drugs, and they would never coddle a drug protector or anybody involved in drugs. So the U.S. granting us political asylum really had to investigate, I mean the U.S. government, and see the true facts of the situation. And therefore, seeing that there were threats to our life, and seeing that we were innocent of these, I was innocent of these charges, that is, therefore, I assume that the reason why they granted the asylum is for the protection of our lives, of my life, from in danger from death, from the death threats being done by Duterte and his administration.
Okay. Now, Mr. Mabilog, you talked about your home in Iloilo. You said it wasn't a palace. It's in a 200 square meter property. And yet you are in the United States right now for 7 years. I'm assuming you're not working. Are you allowed to work there?
No, I'm not working, ma'am.
Yeah. So you're not working. So how are you supporting your family in the last 7 years, sir? Do you have Filipinos supporting you? Is the U.S. supporting you?
My wife is a dual citizen. So she's Filipino and she's a Canadian citizen. So she has been working, and she has been providing for the family for the, not only for the last 7 years, but even when I was still mayor. The salary of a mayor is not enough to support the needs of the family. And I am grateful to have a very supportive and loving wife, Marivic, for financially, for looking for a job and financially supporting us.
Okay.
My daughter is now working, and our son is still in school.
Okay. So just very quickly, before we move on to the hearings in the Quad Committee, did you feel safer in the U.S. immediately? Or were there moments that you actually still feared for your life? Because considering that there were these charges against you in the Philippines by the former president, who was quite popular then and very powerful, that would be like, it would be like walking around with a shadow.
Exactly. Initially, that is what has happened. But knowing that we were granted the asylum, that means that we have the protection of the government, of the U.S. government, in terms of the threats. Mm-hmm. And we, when we were granted the asylum, we were informed that anytime that we feel that we are threatened, we can call a particular number or a police or the police to protect us. So indeed, it is a lot safer.
Okay. Now, in the recent Quad Committee hearing, and this is why you and I are talking today, is our Representative Baronda wants to invite you to speak on the hearing. You have Lieutenant Colonel Espinido, who testified that he received direct orders from President Duterte and De La Rosa to direct the war on drugs in Leyte and then Iloilo, right? So he gave several quotes, yes, that were quite revealing. Ang tanong ko, ano po ba ang ibubulgar ninyo pagdating nyo sa committee hearing?
I'll just state po what is the truth and what are the facts. The truth is that Iloilo City is not the most shabbolized country. Iloilo City has been very active in the fight against illegal drugs, even since in the beginning from 2010 when I became mayor until I left. That I am not involved at anything at all with regards to protecting or anything about illegal drugs. I don't even smoke and things like that. I've never tasted any illegal drug in my life. And if I have all the documents from our minutes of the meeting of our anti-drug abuse council, everything and all the activities and programs that the city have against illegal drugs, just to prove that what they have done is really damaging to my person, and not only to me, Ma'am Karen, but as well as to the other, my fellow mayors, innocent mayors, who were also accused, just to prove that there were human rights violations that were done. So I would like to serve as an inspiration sa mga Pilipino na sa aking palagay ay naging biktima rin nung panahon ng mga Duterte. So all this will be brought out if asked, when asked, by the members of the Quad Committee in Congress, if all right. Given the chance.
Yes, a few more questions before we go. I'm curious, do you plan to file charges against former President Duterte? At the end of the day, your life changed. Instead of you serving, you were voted by the people. 7 years, you've been away from the country. You were in fear for your safety and your families. Do you plan to file charges against former President Duterte?
Actually, the complaint with the ICC was already filed by former Senator Laila De Lima with the ICC. Mm-mm. And as a matter of fact, my name was included in the complaint filed by former Senator Laila De Lima for the trumped up charges made by Duterte. Mm-mm. So I think that is good enough, but personally, while I experience all this pain and this persecution, alam mo, Ma'am Karen, yung sinasabi po na yung nanginginig yung spine, fear, because of nararamdaman ko po yun sa takot for me and my family. But as a true Christian po, I forgive him, because they say po that God always work for the best His plans are always best for you. So I would say po that these 7 years has given me time, for exclusive time for my family. I cook for them. I tend to my kids. I bring them to school. I sleep with my wife, the same bed, for the last 7 years, that I never had the chance while I was in public service. What I mean is that I was so busy, like 5 in the morning, I leave the house already before, and then I would return at 1 in the morning when I'm tired. But now I was able to experience us together being a family for the last 7 years, and that is the most beautiful thing that ever happened to me and my family. And I'm in looking at the brighter side, despite of undergoing this suffering, I'm still grateful to God for bringing me here and making me experience this. But with regards to the case, no more na siguro. I just want peace. But the ICC case is already enough for him and for his whoever is responsible for these human rights violations. If I always believe in justice, that they will have to pay for whatever wrong they have done, and they have to face the consequences of their actions. Karen.
All right. Wow, that was, thank you for opening up like that. But what's surprising is the fact that the ICC case is enough for you, and you don't want justice for yourself. You're not even going to file a case against Duterte. You won't do that anymore.
Personally, ma'am, right now, I haven't talked to my very strong-willed wife and about this yet. But personally, I just want to live in peace, my peace. But who knows? But I still have to consult my lawyers as well. So
right.
I still don't know what to do about that matter.
Do you believe the former president deserves to be in jail?
If I think right now, even if he's not physically in jail, within where he is right now and his situation, I think that is good enough. I hope that he just realizes and it gives him time to repent and, reform himself. And just the fact that probably to admit what he has done would be good enough.
All right. Just two more questions. I think this is important because your return to the Philippines might be politicized. You may have, it's so polarized right now. There is no more unity, right? So some may say that pinababalik kayo ng Marcos administration. Did you get a call from either the president, the speaker of the house? Did you get this call?
No, ma'am. And there is no offer from me to run for public office, no.
None. So you didn't get a call to come back to the Philippines. No offer for you to run for public office under their ticket. But will you run? Do you want to run again as mayor?
What I could say right now, at this particular moment, simple lang po ang gusto ko. Gusto ko lang po umuwi. Gusto ko lang namin ng peace. Gusto ko lang makita yung Iloilo. Gusto ko lang po dumalaw sa puntod ng nanay ko. And kasi namatay po siya, nawala ako. And as well as gusto ko po umuwi sa Pilipinas. For me, that is enough. But in my heart, talaga pong I really want to serve. I've been with the JCs before. I've been with the Lions. I've always been serving all my life, even when I was still a student. I was a student leader. I was with the Kabataan Barangay. All my life, I was for always serving others. And now, I just, after family, it's God. So after God, it's family. So, and I totally surrender to God's plan. If it is His will, then His will be done.
Did the lower house offer you security at least? When are you arriving in the Philippines? Or is it information you can't share? It's up to you, sir.
Yes, ma'am. I haven't had receive yet formally or officially the invitation of from the House to attend their hearings. Through my several friends, they have already been reaching out through them. If in case I receive the invitation, and if it's soon, then I would accept the invitation and I would fly back home immediately. I hope they provide me security. I hope, because that's the primary concern why I left. It's my security. But again, seeing what happened to former Senator Laila de Lima, that she's now free, and among others. So there's a bright light at the end of the tunnel that I see that would give me also ample opportunity to be able to clear my name from all of this.
All right. Well, first of all, Mr. Mabilog, I want to thank you for trusting me and Head Start with your story. I want to thank you just for trusting the show and trusting us, speaking to us with your story. Is there anything you want to add before we go, sir?
Of course, ma'am. My pleasure, po. There has been several attempts from, from all tri-media to be able to talk to me. I've never had. The last interview I had was 7 years ago. I think it was you who also called me during that particular evening. So I'm happy that you're the first, because yes, I trust you, po, and Head Start. Thank you, po, for standing for what is the truth and for standing for those people who are oppressed and persecuted.
Thank you very much. And mag-ingat po kayo, sir. So I'm assuming that at one point we will be seeing you in the hearings. You take care.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. And have a good morning, po.
Now, we also spoke to Justice Secretary Jesus Crispin Remulla on Monday as we get his take on former Iloilo Mayor Jed Mabilog's return. Remulla says the Justice Department can offer him protection if needed.
We can offer him with this protection, if that's the case, especially if Congress asks us to do that. We will offer him a witness protection, and also if he only wants it. But we have to study the cases, the Mabilog cases, because these are very controversial cases and they're very political.